Fingering, knowing rhythmically, etc. And then the other is the tone, how good you sound playing a certain passage. So how good you sound, this is the tone. If this is Skinner tone or... or it's a bigger sound, like how you play the dynamics and all that. And the way to develop this thing, obviously, first is main advice is to get awareness. Because we sometimes, all the time with most musicians, we keep playing in an automatism way, automatically. And then don't be aware. Anything you do automatically means you are not aware of the thing, because it is going on just automatically. So we have to become aware, stop and analyze the thing, and eventually the best idea is that you actually like visualizing yourself from outside. If you record, that's what I learned from the videos, the thousands of videos I have. I learned that by recording these things, I learned to observe myself, what I can improve from there. Because when you watch it from outside, you take a different perspective. And then your tone comes very evident. So you play something with the thumb. And then there are many ways in which something can be played. How something can be played, there are many nuances of that. That you have to distinguish one from the other and analyze this under the proper guidance and recording. That That's why we work with all the students from scratch up to the highest level, update homeworks, recording the student records himself and analyzes what he's doing. And then the tone, you can improve also those interactive videos which have interactive examples there, which I play the student plays. Those are meant to make the student become aware of his tone. So tone matters a lot. And what do you use, of, if you use either super glue on the nails or just nail hardener or acrylic or like the old fashioned old school, it changes your sound. Of course, the length of the nail, it affects the tone. The string you play with this hard tense or not, which string, and of course which instrument you're playing, it affects the tone. Like the other day I explained something with the zero fret stuff, and that one has a different tone also. So you need to learn to play, just like a driver of cars can drive many different cars. Let's say Ferrari, this, the other, Porsche, old Rolls Royce or anything, Volkswagen or whatever car is there, is different. So to be a great driver, it means you need to know how to drive all these different cars. Right? Just like in James Bond movies, like he can drive anything. So these things are there in our training. And that's why one is, you see Chopin or any other Beethoven or great musicians, they were experts also in clarinetes and many different instruments. According to the tone you have to get there, that tone, this is you. So therefore here you have to be specially attentive. And that's why the instrument plays a role, because this is to be the transparent medium between you and the public, right? It's to be crystal-like, to really convey who you are in your tone. So the tone, it is important, and that's why we get in technique. This is part, obviously, of technique and of repertoire. The length of the nail will also affect. So all these factors, you have to be careful how you are playing, right? The angle, even how you hold the guitar, like if I hold it like this, it's the same. Everything will change the tone. The tone most important and most advanced, and at the same time have to be taken care of from scratch, from level one. Right from day one, the tone of a player is important. That's why a beginner, he should, you know, say, have a Stradivarius. But I said, as a beginner player, he should also have a nice instrument which tunes well and that he can get used to improve his tone fluid. Because if you have a guitar that does not tune or give the right note, or it doesn't sound well, then how do you improve the tone? So the tone depends on many things, but nails are also important. All the aspects will be there to enrich your playing once you become deep and not superficial. That's why these tone questions about the tone are not superficial, are very deep. But this doesn't mean that beginners should not get into it. Because I'm a beginner, it doesn't mean that I have to sound bad because I'm a beginner. When I will be advanced, I sound good. That's a nonsense. You have to sound good from day one, even if you play one note, but how you play it, right? Like, for example, in this Paco stuff we were explaining, of this. The thumb here plays totally aligned with the. It's not this way, or say like, yeah, this thumb is not thumb like this or with the nail, because the tone will be not the proper tone. And the proper tone here, which Paco plays, is with the thumb, with the flesh of the thumb from here, from where it marks here in my thumb, I mark it, you see? So from that much, we have to play just with flesh, totally sided. So the same. So the tone, these things, that's why these things have to be learned to the teacher. That you alone cannot do it, because you are not aware enough. You need a mirror who is a teacher to make you succeed in this area. So this tone thing, I learned in 20 years with Paco, I learned a lot of stuff, but still I am learning. Because that's the fun thing about music, that you learn every day something new.